Welcome students, in my new tutorial, and today I'll be teaching you how to make tables with the help of design view. In my last tutorial, I have taught you how to create tables in LibreOffice base with the help of wizard. So without wasting time, directly we will start with the steps. So first of all, as you know already, we are in tables here. I have already selected under database tables. And here on the top, this option is there, create table in design view. So we directly will click upon this option, and as we'll click upon the option, you could see here field name and field type. As earlier we have done in wizard, there were the series of steps which we were following. Now we have not to follow some steps. Directly we will type here the name of the field and the field type. So here I am making one table, like suppose I am giving the name as employee code. I am making the table for the employee, and here for the employee code I want to give as a number. So it could be tiny integer, but the problem with the tiny integer is that length is only 3. So I want to take it as integer. Here I have the more numbers. Now, as you know, this tab where I could write the description, this is not really important. If I want, I could add it. Could write here code of the employee. Then I want to add date of birth of the employee. Then field type, I could write here date. Then third field I want to give as salary, and here I want to give as float because here the length is more. So in the case of salary, I could take float also, integer also, but integer does not support point. I can take decimal also, which will support point. So decimal or float, anything. Suppose I'm taking float only. Salary of employee. Then I want to add the city. So let it be text var character. Okay, so I have added all. See, we have set the design of a table, but till now I have not set the primary key. As earlier I have explained, primary key is a column or set of columns in a table that contains a unique value for each row. So when in datasheet view we will enter the data, at least I want one column where uniqueness should be there. No duplication of data should be there, because when I set the primary key, that column will not have any duplicate values. So in this case, I can't take city as a primary key because city can be duplicated. Suppose I am entering Kalka in a city, so Kalka can be entered plenty of places if there are 100 employees. Same way, salary can also be same. Date of birth can also be same, but employee code we will set separate for each employees. So this I could make as a primary key. I'll right click upon this, and there is option as a primary key, you could see here, and then I'll click on save. So primary key affected. It is saying the column ID belongs to the primary key. If the column is deleted, the primary key will also deleted. Do you really want to continue? Yes. So this has been set, and the file is saved as sale odb. Actually the name of my database is sale, extension is odb, and the name of the table is employee. One thing more I want to teach you. Suppose here I have entered city, the place where employees live. At the bottom, entry required So I have not set anything here. Earlier also I have told you, when I am clicking on employee code, here I have to enter the data, because whenever we are entering the data in primary key and that column is set as primary key, then that column can't remain empty. This I'll explain you when I'll be entering the data. Now the date of birth, I can click here, yes, I want the entry. Salary, this could be no, it depends upon me whether I want to enter the salary or not. City, yes, city I want to enter, that means each employee's place of residence I should know. Default value, suppose I am entering here Kalka, save, and I'll cross the, or I'll close the design view of the table. Under the tables, you could see here now two tables are there. In my earlier tutorial, I taught the way how to create orders table with the help of the wizard. Now we'll be clicking or be using the employee table. We'll fill the data here. So as a result, you could see here, Kalka is already filled, because in default, I have already filled Kalka there. Just see here, I'll just close it once again. I'll go to edit. You could see here under city, I have filled default value as Kalka. I hope it is clear why the Kalka is coming there. So I'll double click employees. So now at least 10 entries I have to fill. The same you have to do when you will be doing your assignment. Suppose I am entering here 101. Date of birth, suppose I am entering 1 month 24, and salary I could fill any, and 102, suppose 30th date, month 2, 75, again 3 11th, month is 11th, and 76. Suppose 35,000. Here this is Pinjor, 104, 9, month 12, 60,000, Pinjor. Now suppose 25th, 10, 80. So like this, I'll fill the data in data sheet view. See, one example now I'll teach you. Just now I am entering the data and it's been filled up. Suppose I don't want to enter the data here. Now this is a primary key. Now employee code I have already given as a primary key. And date of birth, suppose I'll enter anything. Now you could see here the error is coming because this is a primary key. Error in setting a new record. Okay, that means I have to fill the data here. And it should be unique data. Suppose the same value I want to enter, any of the value which I have used earlier. Now in primary key, no duplicate values are allowed. Suppose I am entering here 103 again. Any values I'll put. Now you will say error will come. Error inserting a new record. Violation of unique constant. Duplicate values. I hope this is also clear to you that it will not allow any duplicate values. So I'll save the data here. And as a result, I'm able to make a table directly with the help of design view. If I'll double click on this, I can see my table. One thing more, if I'll go to the design view, and suppose this is I've selected this field name. Now this is having the primary key. This also I'll select, and then primary key. Now it is showing two primary keys. I could use two primary keys also, and in that sense it will be called as composite primary key. Now what is composite primary key? Actually, it is a type of a primary key that consists of two or more columns or fields in a database file. Now, why we need it? Why do we need composite primary key? These actually combined columns uniquely identify each record in a table when a single column alone cannot provide uniqueness. So in some cases we may need to give two primary keys. Okay, when single primary key is not able to identify each record in a table, or a proper uniqueness is not seen. So in that way I could give two primary keys, and in that case it is called composite primary key. I hope it is clear. So just now I'll not give as a composite primary key, just for teaching purpose I showed you. So let it be the same as earlier it was. So now you have learned both the ways how to create a table, even how to create a database, creating a table with a design view, with a wizard view. So with this I am closing my tutorial. And if you like my explanation, then please do like, share and comment, and also subscribe my channel if you have not subscribed it earlier. Okay, bye bye, take care, meet you soon in my next tutorial.